All right, PFF's best remaining players. It all starts with Maurice Hurst. He's been our boy for quite a while. We had a feeling that something could happen, though, because he had the heart issue at the combine, wasn't able to work out. He did go to his pro day. It sounded like he got signed off on, but he's our guy, but he's dropping probably just because of the heart. He's awesome.
Yeah, we know he's off some boards. This could even turn into a Lyle Collins situation where maybe no one even wants to touch him. Maybe no one has him left on their board. But if that's the case, round one, we can make sense of it. But if he drops past round two, round three, then we'll start to get worried. So, yeah, it's definitely the heart condition with him.
Yeah, look, when he's went on the field, though, highest grade we've ever given an interior defensive lineman. So he's been just outstanding.
Yeah.
Beyond that, we've got Josh Jackson from Iowa. Our number one corner on the board, a little bit scheme specific when you compare him to some of the other corners that have gone, though. Is he just a zone guy? Can he play man? I think that's the big question mark for teams right now.
Yeah, he was really excelled when he was playing off cover three there at Iowa. So that was his sort of calling card, was off coverage, zone coverage. A lot of teams are wary of drafting zone corners in the NFL. You want man cover skills. His man cover skills were not nearly as on par with guys like Jaire Alexander, like Denzel Ward, who did go in the first round. But you look at that playmaker ability like that, rare playmaking ability. Reminds me of someone like Marcus Peters. I think he'll be a steal forever, whoever does get him.
I think he'll be a steal. I think teams might be afraid of the 4.5-ish 40 as well. And then there's Harold Landry, a guy that we've gone to bat for. I know this hurts you a lot. We've gone to bat for, especially because of his 2016 season. And again, it's not a terrible surprise because 2017, he was banged up and he was not nearly as productive.
This screams Carl Lawson from a season ago where Lawson dropped all the way to the fourth, became our highest graded pass rusher as a highest graded rookie pass rusher. That feels like Harold Landry right now because as a pass rusher, what you want in today's NFL, pass rushing ability, you look at that bull rush, he can do it all. He has all the moves. I know he gets criticized for only going to that dip rip outside move, but he flashes all the moves. If you watch enough of his tape, if you go back to 2016, it was just the fact that he kept winning with the outside move, so he kept going to it, and his 2017 was a step back with injury.
His 2016 pass rush grade better than Bradley Chubb, who went number 5 overall. Those are our top 3 players, some defensive talent still remaining on the board.